So, hello everybody. I'm Nello Onye. I'm a developer and a reporter. I work with Tom and a few other people here. I've worked with quite a few people in here, actually, surprisingly. I'm that guy on most places, JoeAndreal on Twitter. So, my talk today is talking about a couple of things that, in my opinion, are nice things, such as the true humanism that you were mentioning there. A lot of people, they're good things, but a lot of people just seem not to use them. I find them useful. They're not all great. They're just mostly my opinion about things I think are good and people should be using more than they do. Some of them are documented, some of them are not. But the first one on my list is using Perl for Perl number version. So since I think Perl 5.10, I think it was, you're able to load certain features like, you know, say, switch and smart button and all that stuff. But not a lot of people know that you can actually load all that up at once. So I think it was about 5.16 where you're able to use feature and specify the number that loads all the features all together. So if you say use feature 5.24, it actually loads all the, say, switch, post direct, and all the things that are available at that version of Perl. All the the ones that used to be experiments that are no longer much experimental. So in this example here, I'm just showing, for example, I'm using the state keyword, postfix dereferencing, and slice hashing. So that's quite handy, that's quite nifty. But if you make a simple change like that, just delete the feature and use the number itself, it does exactly the same thing, and the output is just the same. So that's someone like Tom will tell me that he likes when I make him write lists, so I think that's quite useful. So that's the first one on my list.
Do you have to use 5.024, not just 5.24?
You have to use 5.024, because that's the full version number. It's 5.024.000.
You can use V5.24, but that gives nasty syntax errors on calls on tools to support the V syntax. So I think it's before 5.6, or on 5.6. I think in 5.8 has V literals, so.
Well, this one works.
Well, you can get a better error message, it really doesn't work.
So the other one, the next one on my list was TextCSV. I know you're going to say, like, we all use TextCSV, nobody bundles their own CSV parsers. You'd be surprised, but anyway. So a typical example is, you know, this is how it's written in the synopsis. You would load the objects, pass it a file handle, get the headers off, and this will give you an array of hash refs, with the keys being the header names. I should have put the line numbers in there. I will next time. But that's a lot of code for what you're trying to do. If you actually made that change, get rid of all that stuff and just loaded the CSV function, you can change that to that and does exactly the same thing. So a lot of, this is actually the reason I wrote this talk, because we get a lot of example code coming in, and there's some CSV parsing involved. And everybody does that. And I'm quite surprised that everybody uses text CSV, but nobody knows that exists. So that for me is like, I'm like, yeah, win all the way. So I like that. That's a good one. Next thing on my list is Scala. So I already said that I don't like writing a lot. And this one doesn't save me a lot of lines. But another thing I quite hate is pre-declaring variables. So in this particular line, that one up there, like, I'm just declaring something and assigning it to nothing. Like, I could have actually dropped the equals empty list there and it would work the same. But I don't like doing that. I like to know when I'm assigning, if I can assign it to the value straight away, I prefer doing that. So there's a nifty thing that people from, we stole from Perl 6, which is gather take, which is a tool for building up lists. And so if I actually make that change there, I can change it to that. Now, like I said, it doesn't save me lines of code, it actually adds a line. Actually adds that one. So, but I think I prefer to do this. Like I said, this is my opinion. They're not, all these things aren't good advice. I just think this is better. okay, so yeah, I think this is a good thing. Not a lot of people do that. We don't even have it in our local, what's it called? Burn-up CPAN. This is one of the modules that we're allowed to use, so I find that a shame. But
all requests welcome.
I'm not touching it. Yeah, I'm here to talk about dependency health. You can deal with that. So this one is another nice one. So everybody's heard of list utils and list more utils and list all utils, which combines both of them. But not a lot of people know that there's a similar feature for hashes as well. It doesn't have quite as many functions. We don't do as much with hashes as we do with lists, I guess. So quite often, this is quite a common thing to do. You want to pull out the pairs from a hash where all the values are defined or where all the values meet some criteria. So this is how you would normally do something like that. You know, pull out the keys, grab the defined values, and then you'd map back to get back the pairs. If you used hash more utils, you could do that in one line.
Jeez, I just wrote that code yesterday.